What is going on, guys? We are back and we got Comp vs Black Oblivion for Ulti playoffs, and this is like pretty interesting. Her Dragon team could be Scarf Greninja or Scarf Lando, and Specs Hydra or Z Move Hydra. And on the on the other team, my boy Archie is trolling me in the chat. He's in my Discord. What a troll. On the other side, we see potential Bandit or Assault Vest Tita. Let me think real quick. I mean, he has Gyarados to check Volcarona if he stays in regular form, so this doesn't have to be Assault Vest Tita. I know that Blunder used that on the Jamba team because it was a bit weak to Volk because he changed some other set. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's defensive Mew on this team. He needs it for Zygarde, unless his Pharaoh's on his max defense, but I'm assuming this is more a Death Pharaoh. This team looks like really annoyed by Magnezone, but thankfully his opponent didn't bring a Magnezone. I think, like, luckily for him. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is Ashgren. Oh, actually, I just said it could be Scarf earlier, right? Yeah, it could be Scarf Point or it could be Specs Ashgren, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Like, I'm just thinking that those are the two options. I don't think it's like Life or Protein. Even though that set is really good, people don't use it that much. Or, like, I haven't seen it in forever. Yeah, I'm thinking it's Zemo Victini or Scarf Victini, actually. Let me think. Yeah, the team is a bit slow, so Scarf Victini makes sense. Okay, so it's Scarf Greninja. That means the Landorus could be Sky Strike then, yeah. Oh, Seed Bomb Ferrothorn, is that for Suicune? What the fuck is this? No, never mind, it gets Power Whip anyway. It has more PP, I think, than Power Whip. It has less power and it doesn't miss. What is that for? That's really interesting. Protect Ferrothorn, okay. So Black Oblivion showed Udyr. He can still have a Z-move. We don't know that. Oh, he showed leftovers. Never mind. Okay, he doesn't have a Z-move from bed. I didn't pay attention that he showed lefties. No, I know. So yeah, the Z-move user is either the Tren or the Hydra then. Yeah, actually, defensive Lando makes sense on this team. Now that I think about it, his Zygarde matchup. It also helps versus stuff like Alolan Marowak, even though that's not that common. But it can at least switch in one time. But yeah, I could see this being a Fireium Z Heatran, like Z Magma Storm. Magma Storm off power. Taunt Toxic? I don't know. Oh my fucking god, I was just about to say. It's probably not substitute, right? Because he didn't show leftovers, but like, it's still an option. I know BTB made a team that Mazari used in World Cup that had, I think it also had Subtran with Z with Fireium Z. I'm pretty sure this is Z Fire move. He's just gonna go for Magma Storm and, Fireium Z is just gonna kill this Gyarados here if he goes for it. Yeah, Inferno Overdrive. Before Inferno Overdrive, show me the power. There it is. Oh, is it Bloom Doom? No, it's Inferno Overdrive as expected. Bob. Yeah, Bloom Doom was another option that I didn't think about. But yeah, Inferno Overdrive. So got that correct. That it's potentially is that. So I think this is just a crunch of pursuit coming. Yeah, okay, really nice play on Black Oblivion's part, catching him on the pursuit, getting more damage on the Tita, and that crit sucks. Wow. So yeah, this game is pretty much over. Black Oblivion put in so much work with his Tren that crit obviously sucks, because otherwise Tren would have been dead. I think what he would have done, he would have either gone to Greninja and clicked U-turn on the Tita after hits if he didn't crit it with the off power, or he could have gone into like, he could have also gone to Mawile after. Depending on the set, if Mobile had something to pressure the Ferrothorn. I think he would have just gone Grand Click U-turn, to be honest. If he didn't get a crit. But this obviously gives him, like, puts him even more ahead than he already was. Like, he already get a nice... I'm not the biggest fan of the Protect play. Could it still celebrate? So this team doesn't have a Scarf, right, it seems, unless it's Scarf Mew. So he's gonna go for Star Power. I assume that kills because Trainer's at 25 and it's offensive. What I meant to say is I don't really like the Protect play earlier. Just in case there's a sub, like, it's unlikely to be sub because it didn't show lefties, but still, like, that was definitely an option that you have to consider. Like, the set is not that unknown. The set has been used in World Cup, like I said. So it's something that you have to think about. But it also didn't cross my mind at first. So, like, so I'm pretty sure this is Specs Hydreigon. Like, that just makes the most sense to me. Scarf doesn't make sense when you already have a Scarf Gren, and that's some nice wall breaking power. Like, Specs Hydra, I assume it rocks up. Now you can potentially tweet KO Celesteela if it's Fist F. I'm actually not sure. You probably need some prior damage though. But if you attack, like, if you get like 20% on Steela, you probably tweet KO with Dark Pulse. That's just my head calc though. I haven't been running the calc. So I assume he has to go for Rock Slide to kill this. Or Hydro Pump, depending on what he has. Pretty sure U-turn doesn't kill because he has a defense boost. U-turn might kill if it's max attack, but most of the time they run only like 40 or 60 attack and the rest in special attack, these Greninjas. Which has U-turn, Rock Slide, and then Hydro Pump, Ice Beam. Or, like, instead of Hydro Pump, you can also run Spikes sometimes, or Toxic Spikes. Oh, he has Surf. Wow, that's rare. So, yeah, if he had a water move, that's obviously fine. So, he doesn't want to miss, okay? That's just for consistent hit. Like, for overall... Always hitting the move, but, like, giving up some base power. Okay, that's... I kind of respect that. So he tries to pivot and Pharaoh on a Leech Seed, and he reads that and goes for Flamethrower. You can go for Leech Seed here on the switch. That's a good play if he goes for Leech Seed here. And okay, just Flamethrower again, that's also fine. So this is Earthquake HP Ice, I assume, in the last two slots. His Lando doesn't really threaten the Celesteela at all. So he's probably just gonna, like, U-turn out into, I don't know. Like, the Celesteela is really annoying for Black Oblivion. So the game is not over yet. Like, Black Oblivion was an advantage early, but, like, Celesteela just walls his entire team after Heatran died. And yeah, Hydreigon can threaten it with Specs Fire Blast, obviously, but he has to get that in. If he gets it in on a Leech Seed, that's not gonna work out. Yeah, that Surf is gonna bounce off. He can just, he double C that pretty thing, like a U-turn. I think Heavy Slam was free there, but it's fine. Yeah, he can seeds again now. He just has to be careful that he doesn't waste all his PP. If he seeds again here on the Hydra, he's in such a good position. Okay, he Flamethrowed. I'm pretty sure he's just gonna go for Specs Fire Blast, because I don't think Dark Pulse threatens this enough, because the Celesteela is so annoying for him. Like, he wants to make sure to threaten this out, right? Like, I assume a Spec Fire Blast would do around 50 to this, 55 maybe. That's just a head calc. I mean, he can protect here, but after that turn earlier went for sub on a protect, maybe he's scared to go for protect again. But this is not gonna have, like, sub or any setup. This doesn't get any good setup moves, right? It gets Charge Beam. I've seen that on a ladder, but that's no set. And that's not gonna be too scary for him in here anyway, if he protects. Yeah, it's Specs Fire Blast, I assume. Yeah, that's around 53. If that's really Specs, I mean, my headcard works pretty much on point. I said something with 50, right? But, like, that's still crazy how Celesteela eats that up. So he's gonna protect it, because the Celesteela is too important. I know that Black Oblivion can switch out here, and it's kind of obvious that he's gonna protect again. But there's no point in not protecting here. Like, you just get free leftovers if he switches anyway. The Celesteela is, like, too important to not protect and risk it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Backup Living doesn't really have anything to pressure, so he's just gonna spam Fire Blast. I assume we're gonna see the Mew come out here. So Backup Living can technically double into like, actually, how does he beat the Mew as well? The Mew is also really annoying for him. So yeah, this, yeah, he has this with Dark Pulse to threaten the Mew, like, but this is already at 51 and after Rocks, and if it's at 39 and if it takes more Leechy, it's gonna be really low. So he goes in the Mew as expected. This is not gonna do too much because of the lefties plus Leech Seed recovery. You can just click Will-O-Wisp, right? I assume Black Oblivion is gonna let his Landorus get burnt and then get a slow U-turn on the Mew. Or he can get his Ferro get burnt. I think Comp might not wanna default because the rocks are kinda important to chip to pressure this Hydreigon a bit. Yeah, that's crazy. A lot of ulti games are happening today. The deadline is later, but like, I also have to play my then Premier League game. But yeah, my team is too far in the back, so like, it's not looking too good. But I'm gonna try to pull out a win. Okay, he has Ice Beam. I mean, Ice Beam worked, but it would've also killed the Lando if he tried to pivot land on a Wisp. This Greninja is dead now to, there's a free softbolt. Greninja is dead to rocks. This is not gonna do anything. You can just softbolt all the damage off and get even more health back with the lefties. No reason not to click it, yeah. And wait, what is... Is this Chopperberry? I don't think it's Shed Shell. I think it's this Chopperberry, right? Yeah, Chopperberry helps him a bit because Medicham is really annoying for his team. It also helps for his Tapu Bulu and Alakazam. Yeah, that makes sense on this team actually, yeah. I like that. So I assume he's gonna go for like Leech Seed or Spikes here. Spikes would potentially force Comp to defog later in the game, and that would get rid of the rocks on Black Oblivion side, so Hydreigon is not that pressured. I can see Comp trying to go Ferro on a Leech Seed here, but just burning this is fine, yeah. Yeah, this works for him. Like, Leech Seed is not the end of the world at all. Now you can go to Ferro or to Celesteela. Because Mew doesn't really do much to this. Yeah. Nice double Leech Seed play. And yeah, the burn of Ferrothorn, I've said this before. Burn off helps these Pokemon like Ferrothorn. I mean, Celesteela and Toxic Specs are new Pokemon that didn't exist last gen. But these fat Pokemon with like Leech Seed or like Recovery in general, like they just get so much harder to take down kinda with the burn nerf. Also, they're all steel type, so you can toxic them. So this is a good play. He could sack off his Greninja here, but and then go into Hydreigon. I can see him doing that. Sack the Gren here. Yup. Bring out the Hydreigon and click Dark Pulse. Because Dark Pulse kind of gets a kill. Yeah, Celesteela is at 48 after rocks, so he has to pick his 40 here. If he loses the Mew, that would be really annoying, so yeah, he goes Ferro. As that actually did nothing, what the f... Okay, so maybe that wasn't Specs damage on the Celesteela, I didn't calc it earlier. So we're gonna calc this real quick. Hydreigon, Choice Scarf versus Ferrothorn. Dark Pulse, yeah, so that's Scarf damage, wow. That's crazy. I thought it was Specs, so... I should have run the Kalk versus the Celesteela. I overestimated. I thought Celesteela was just the bulkiest thing in the world. That's why. What the fuck? I thought Fireblast does like 53, but like Specs would have done more than. I'm just gonna Kalk versus Max Spadef Ferrothorn to make if it's Specs, to see if it's potentially Specs. Let's say Sassy, like just some Spadef nature. Yeah, even if it's, yeah, the case, so it's not Specs Hydra. So my bad, guys. You probably, some of you probably are yelling, were yelling at the screen earlier when I saw it, was Specs on the Celesteela. But yeah, it's fine. Mistakes happen. I just have never ran the cog, and I have been using Celesteela like mixed defensive, and I have been using Spadef and Fizzdef, so it depended on the Celesteela set. And if the Celesteela was Spadef, I thought that it could have been Specs damage. But yeah, this obviously works better for comp, the 1v1 Pharaoh versus Pharaoh Thorn, because the opposing Pharaoh is burned and he doesn't have lefties to negate the burn, and he gets back leftovers. So he doesn't lose anything from spamming Leech Seed here. Let me calc real quick Hydreigon versus Celesteela. So we're just gonna calc versus the standard defensive spread. So Specs Firebase would have done, oh my god, that would have done way more. Okay, my bad. I overestimated Celesteela's bulk a lot. I should have run the calc earlier. Like, if you make a choice scarf. Yeah, okay, then that makes more sense. But I think he had a bit more speed depth than this spread. It's not my internet that died. Yeah, he's taking time. Because yesterday I had some internet issues. So seed bombs. I mean, it works as well because he gets some more chip. But I think just spamming Leech Seed is fine as well. Like, he has enough Leech Seed BP anyway. I think Black Oblivion is just gonna sack his Ferrothorn. And then he's gonna go Hydreigon and just threaten this with a Fire Blast. And it's sort of 50-50 then if he goes Hydra. He only has like two more Rock Switches with Hydra, so he has to get the play correct, kinda. Huh. Like, because if a comp goes on the Mew on a Fire Blast after when Hydreigon comes out, that comp is just in a really nice position, because Mew should be able to E2, right? But if he goes for Dark Pulse and catches him. Okay, he goes Morwen instead. So maybe he has Fire Fang. That would change the whole situation here. Or he's just trying to SD up and then. Because I know if he SD to plus 6, you Oko Ferrothorn. Like, I don't know if Morwen instead. I don't know if he has Fire Fang. Or if he's gonna have to SD up to, like, threaten this. Expect either the hard Mew switch or to with this, or I expect the Leech Seed, obviously. But yeah, this is actually not that bad for Black Oblivion as I thought. Completely for, yeah, yes, this juicy Mawile here. I mean, you would expect Mawile to run SD Sucker Punch, Thunder Punch and Playroff, but like, I don't know, this team has a fire move on Tren and has a fire move on Hydreigon, so I'm like, I don't think there's a Fire Fang on this team, to be honest. But yeah, the one thing, like, this Tren is cool and everything, sub and Z move is really cool, like, put it in work. But like, I can see Scizor becoming a really big threat to this team, like, in general, overall. If the heat drink goes down, like, because the sub already costed health. Like, I know you can keep the sub on certain mons, but it just feels like Scizor can become really annoying to this team when this gets weakened. This can get in plus 2 bullet punch range pretty easy too. So he's just an SD to plus 6 and then play roughing. But yeah, that's what I thought, if he doesn't have Fire Fang. Mm-hmm. Because even if the Mew wisps this, like, a okay, he has knockoff, okay. I thought he had, I didn't know he had knockoff, I thought he had Thunder Punch, Sucker, and Play Rough. So I thought he would go to plus 6 and then Play Rough, but this works. She's gonna protect. I mean, Black Oblivion can just spam knockoff here, he doesn't lose anything, right? Like, if you SD here and the Celesteela goes for Flamethrower, I think that's a potential choke play, so you just spam knockoff, right? Damn, this game has been taking longer than the other the first game of the other series. Yeah, I completely agree with spamming knockoff. Then, like in the other series, there was the first series where someone used stall, right? Basically, and the game was not as long as I expected. It was pretty short. But yeah, I think Maul should definitely run enough speed for a Celesteela, right? Like, most Celesteela run minus speed nature. He gets a double protect, which is pretty lucky. But it doesn't matter, he still clicks knockoff and kills this. I guess he can try to solo with Celesteela. He can sack his Mew here. And then try to get a double protect and then solo with Celesteela. That's an option. Because I'm pretty sure this is not an Ice Beam range. Yeah, exactly. He's gonna try to solo with Celesteela. I think that was his only option anyways. Because the Mew dies to Dark Pulse from Hydra if this goes down. So that was... if he sacked Celesteela, he lost. So he has to get a double protect here. Black Oblivion said GG, so I think he didn't get it. Yeah, he didn't get the double protect. So Black Oblivion wins game 1.